love bugs. It's Rosalind back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed. I'm doing blessed and highly favored, and I definitely hope the same for you. And if this is your first time coming to my channel, much love to you and welcome. And to my returning sub, my growing, extended, beautiful family, thank you so much just for dropping lines, requesting videos, vlogs, and just, you know, opening your mind up to different things that it will help you on your current path you are currently taking. So, with that being said, much love to all. Namaste, love and blessings, love and light, and many blessings are definitely coming your way. And if you've been watching my videos for a while and have not already, what are you waiting for? Like and subscribe, even hit that notification bell so you know when I'm about to upload my next video. And if you feel like you're comfortable enough, go ahead and drop me a line or two. I love to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me. Or even if it's about the positive feedback of the content of my video, or you're just opening up, tell me about your empathic gift and how it has impacted your life into a positive direction. Or if you feel like the video has, you know, just gave you good vibes, or, you know, just gave you good insight, and you feel like you want to, you know, share it, go ahead and do so. Share it with a loved one or friend, or just give me a thumbs up, like, and even share it on your social media favorites. And thank you so much for stopping by my channel. I hope you're able to get something out of the content of my video. And today my video is about Twin Flame 101. Hey, Okas. Telling the difference between your ego and your intuition talking. Yeah, there's a lot of times, especially right now, when you're on towards your blessing, that ego will come like crazy. It will, you know, talk to you, try to talk you out of things, try to scare you, pump fear into your heart, pump doubt into your mind, and stuff like that. And, you know, some of us can't tell the difference between, okay, is my ego talking to me, or is my intuition? You have to be able to tell the difference between those, because it will sabotage your path. So, it's just like, when you have to think about it, you're going towards something. It could be, oh, I'm sorry, I sat up here and didn't even tell y'all what I'm listening to today, my bad. It's called Indian Flute Meditation Music, Positive Vibes, Instrumental Music for Meditation and Yoga. I'll post that link in the description box below. But yeah, back to that. Telling the difference between your intuition and your ego. It's just like with your ego. Your ego is something that is kind of keeps us in our comfort zone. Keeps us to where we don't want to change. And like, it could be you're going for this job, and it is just like your ego is telling you, you know, you've been trying out for all these other jobs, what, you know, and you never got it. What makes you think you're going to get this one? And, you know, and it will pump that energy towards doubt and negative vibes towards your way to make your frequency go down. And, you know, and you're just like, okay, I might not get that job, you know. And it's already, you know, you already put in the wheels of motion that you're not going to have this job. But if it's your intuition is like, you know what? You got so many things in common with this job. You do this and this and this and this and that. You might be an asset to this company. You know, you might not have been qualified for those other jobs. You might not, you never know what God was, you know, blocking you from to get you towards this one. So just because you didn't fill in for that slot or fill in for that one, and it might have been towards the talents that you had, but this one is that perfect match for you to where it's not going to feel like a job. It's not going to seem tedious. You're not going to get bored with it real quick. Because I don't know about some of y'all empaths or helpers, but me, if I do something too much and it's like it just feels like it's in a hamster wheel, I will get bored with it real quick. Even though it might be something I enjoy, but, you know, I want something that's really going to make me, you know, passionate about it like this. You know, if I feel like I'm talking about the same content too much, I'll switch it up. Like, okay, you know, I don't want to bore somebody to death talking about the same thing over and over again. You know, what other things can I bring to the table that other people might can relate to, or they might be currently struggling with right now, but just doesn't have the voice to come out and ask anybody because they're worried about judgment or how somebody might see them. So it's just like, you know, those are intuitions. It's like something that is pushing you towards a positive goal in your life, towards a milestone and a step that you weren't scared. You were scared and uncomfortable with taking it before. You know, and there's, you know, the ego, when the ego see that you are, you know, is just going to allow it to just go ahead and say what it wants to say and you go about your business, you won't really pay attention to that ego part of you anymore. You know, I had a good question come up towards me today, and I was talking to a good friend of mine, and they asked me, how does it make you not egotistical or, you know, ego tripper, you know, egomaniac for the things that you are? You know, some people think, oh, she might be thinking she's high and mighty because she's Prince's daughter. No, I don't. You know, the things that I went through and how people had treated me has very well humbled me and kept me very well grounded. And seeing what money and power can really do to somebody, it makes me just want to push out more love and light than anything. You know, Bump being whose child I am, just pay attention to what I'm trying to present to you, what things you can overcome and all these things. Those are the things that are very well important to me, you know, about how I can impact somebody's life in a positive way, not because who I'm related to. So it's just like, you know, that has humbled me a lot, because before this, I never knew the actual truth of that. So it's just like going through all these things, it has kept me grounded, has kept me humble. And just to know that my ego has got me in a lot of trouble. Me, you know, just doing stuff that's very, you know, probably invasive to myself as well as other people, or having rash and rational, you know, rational thoughts and impulse thoughts without thinking it through first. So you have to really, you know, sit down and listen to your intuition and see what it's trying to tell you, what positive things it's trying to push you towards. You know, the ego is just like, you're like, Rosalind, how do I control the ego? The ego, it's like you have to train your mind to get out of the habit of doubting yourself, not having that confidence within yourself. You know, you seek it amongst other people when you need to seek it amongst yourself. That's what you need to do. You know, allow yourself to stop going towards, you know, doing stuff without clearly thinking it all the way, because it can mess you up as well as your future and your path, you know, as well as other people around you. That's why I try to be very careful about how I word things, or try to make sure that I'm very clear on what I say, because I never want to offend somebody or allow them to misconstrue what I'm trying to say. So it's just like I always try to make sure that, you know, I'm mindful, because I've done that in the past. So it's not like I'm telling you I'm high and mighty, because I had to learn from the mistakes, you know, because there's times my mom told me, you are not tactful. You are just, you have no kind of coot at all. And you don't care about how you betray on people's feelings. And it's just like, I want to be mindful and discern about how I project myself towards people. You know, people are always going to have something negative to say about you, especially if you're pushing out something positive. But, you know, the right people that are in my corner will see me for who I truly am and know that I'm nothing but trying to do is allow you to see things in a different way to benefit you on your current path, benefit you as just a person yourself, or how you present yourself, or how you can project yourself in a positive way, how you can impact somebody's life that can help them to do the same thing. So allow your instincts and your intuition guide you on the current path. You know, your ego is just basically a fear pocket that we will run to a fail safe kill switch, you know, when we, oh, okay, it's becoming too hard, or oh, I can't understand this, and want to run back and go to that, you know, that comfort zone, which I, you know, I'll tell you, I'm suspect of doing all the time. I keep it real with you. So, you know, allow yourself to see the things that you need to see, and, you know, let it lead you towards the current path you need to be on. You know, allow your intuitions to be able to guide you. You know, it's just the universe putting a download in your body and let you know, hey, this is the wrong path that you're going on, or hey, you need to go ahead and put a little bit more effort in it, or hey, you're being too hard on yourself, or you know what, go ahead and take a break. You know, anything that is going to push anything positive towards your life, and it's that feeling that you get, or, you know, is telling you to stay away from something, you know, go ahead and listen to that. You know, but if it's telling you to stay away from it out of fear because of change, now that's the one thing you shouldn't listen to. So I hope you are able to resonate with this video. Like and subscribe, even hit that notification bell so you know when I'm about to upload my next video. Drop me a line. I love the chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me. Or even give me a thumbs up, share it with a loved one, a friend, or even share on your social media favorites. Send as much love and light and positivity as you possibly can. And know that you are blessed and highly favored and truly loved. And know there is always somebody out there praying for your better days. And I will see you on my next video. Much love and light and namaste to you. Peace and be wild.